measurement of the effective diameter, right? So measurement of effective diameter means it is nothing but the pitch diameter. Effective diameter is also called pitch diameter. In order to measure this effective diameter, there are two methods. In general, we can be used two-wire method, three-wire method, right? So based on the size of the wire, what we are using those wires, either two or three, we can able to measure the effective size of the or effective diameter of the given screw thread. How to measure it? So that what we discussing in the previous class. So like this, in the lab also we are going to perform this experiment in the MMM lab individually, whether it is a two wire method or the three wire method. The procedure remain the same, only the formulas and the number of wires or the rods, what you are seeing on the screen, it going to differs. That's it, right? Identical wires will be used, whether it is two or three wire method. In the last class, we discussed this two wire method. So like this, on the handheld micrometer, two wires will be held in the opposite positions. The wires will come in contact with the pitch line, the flank of the thread, so the effective diameter can be measured once before placing the screw thread on the standard roller. Then R1 reading will be taken, then reading will be taken with the screw thread gauge. So by using the formulas, in the last class we did these things about the two-wire method, how to use the two-wire method to measure the effective diameter, or you can call it as pitch diameter for the given screw thread, right? So till this, told in the last class also, this is important. Either two wire method or three wire method, small derivation, the equation they will going to ask, right? Usually if you refer the VT question paper which I have sent in the WhatsApp, you can just go through it, right? So in the last class, we are discussing about this three-wire method. As you all know that one, three-wire method means, as the name implies, three wires. You can see on the screen, the image, there are three wires will be there, or three rods. You can call it as three rods will be used. Two on one side, one on the other side of the screw thread. By using this arrangement, you can able to measure the effective diameter by using three-wire method. Compared to the two-wire method, the previous one, the first method, this method is more accurate because more the wire, more the contact with the pitch diameter, that is the flank of the thread, so that we can able to get more accurate values, more the contacts, right? So exactly more the value, the known diameter or pitch diameter can be found out using this. So similar to this, you are going to perform in the lab three-wire method, two on one side, one on the other side. So this how to get the equation to calculate the effective diameter or pitch diameter of the given screw thread. A small derivation like what we discussed in the two-wire method, here also we are going to discuss the same thing, but instead of two, three wires we are going to consider. In the last class, I have shown this video. How the person uses that on the lathe to check the effective diameter by using three wires, right? So on the screen, what you are seeing, see, these are the three wires which will be using. It is more accurate on for measuring the effective diameter. On the image, what you can able to see, this is the given screw thread, the left figure, the cursor you can able to see, right? This is the screw thread and three circles you can able to see. There is three wires, one on the one side, two on the other side, and these two, what you are seeing, these are the anvils, right? These are the anvils of the handheld micrometer. It has to be placed properly, otherwise effective value or effective diameter will not be obtained. The adjustment need to be made properly. This image, this portion of it has been enlarged over here in the second figure, what you are seeing, and it has been mentioned with the denotations. See here, M You can able to see here m. You can see the first image also. M means it is the diameter over the wires. So because it is completely been shown, that's why from this point is represented as m. But here only one portion of the screw that is shown, only the top portion. So for that reason, here it has been mentioned as double arrow mark m, right? Diameter over the wires. Again, E represent effective diameter. You can observe in the image here. This is the effective diameter. You can observe in the first image also, effective diameter, right? Again, D represent diameter of the wires, small d. This is the wire which is being selected. What is being showing in this image, right? This is the actual one, the small d, what it is being represented here. Again, H represent this H, height of the center of the wire of rod or rod from the effective diameter. The small h value, it is this height of the center of the wire or rod from the effective diameter. From this line, you can observe, to this center of the wire, it is small h. Theta will be the angle of the thread or thread angle. R will be the radius of the wire. This is the wire, what it has been representing, right? This is shown. Capital H represent depth of the thread. From this point is depth, capital H. So this D will represent major diameter of the thread because it is external thread from crest to crest. It is major diameter, capital D. This image, I will take it in the next slide again. So it will be helpful to get the equations out of it, right? So again, you can see the same image I have taken over here. In this, so in order to get the equation, the value of m, see, two triangles again need to be considered, right? In that, the first triangle ABD, see this image, figure B, ABD is ABD. You can see the cursor ABD. This it has been talking about. This triangle I have taken here, the bottom, you can see here, ABD. This ABD, I have taken this triangle so that it will be easy for you for the getting the equations. Consider this triangle ABD, right? So from this triangle, cosecant theta, right? Similar to the two-wire method here, cosecant theta. See, cosecant theta means it can be represented by 1 by sine theta. All you know the trigonometric function, right? 1 by sine theta. But sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse, right? So cosecant theta will become hypotenuse by opposite. So for this triangle ABD, hypotenuse is with respect to this AD. This is hypotenuse, AD by opposite. Opposite means this one. So AB, what is being, which is represented here, right? AD by AB. Consider this triangle ABD. Cosecant theta is 1 by sine theta, whereas sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. So finally, going to get AD by AB. This is hypotenuse, this is opposite, right? Now here, you can observe, AD is equal to AB into cosecant theta by 2. AD by AB is equal to cosecant theta. But theta value is, you can see here, the cursor, theta is theta by 2, right? You can observe here also in this image, the main image, figure B, ABD, this value, it is theta by 2, half of the angle of the thread. You can observe here, this is theta, the entire one. But half of it here at this junction, it is theta by 2. So AD is equal to AB cosecant theta by 2. See this AB, what you are seeing in this image, the main image AB, it is written in the terms of D by 2, right? Because AB is the radius of this small wire, the diameter of the wire, right? AB is diameter of the wire. So AB represent, it is the radius now. So that's why D by 2 cosecant theta by 2. So finally, one more triangle you can able to consider. here. You can able to see your here another triangle D E. Here there is no designation here, that for that reason I have shown it as a yellow color here, right? You can observe here in this one more triangle I am representing. I'm getting from this main image D E, and there is no representation here. For the sake of representation, I'm taking it as F here. You can see here on the screen yellow color, right? There is no F here in the main image. Don't get confused. I will tell that one, right? D E, for the namesake, you consider this as F now, right? Here, if this triangle is being considered, see now, similarly, the cot theta, right? All of you know cot theta is equal to 1 by tan theta, trigonometric function, right? Here I represent it again here. For the reference, cot theta is 1 by tan theta, but tan theta is opposite by adjacent. So finally, adjacent by opposite. For this triangle, adjacent by opposite. Adjacent means this particular one. This adjacent is this one. Then again, opposite, right? This. So from this equation, you can able to represent like this. H is equal to DE cot theta by 2, because theta is, the value of theta is theta by 2, right? And this H, why this H is been represented here? You can be see over here, this, because there is no F in the main image. This is only for representation. This actually the distance is H. You can see here, this is the H. You can observe from this point to this part is H. So that's why H is equal to DE cot theta by 2. Again, DE means, you can see over here, DE, the main image, from this point to this point, DE, it is P by 2. Half of the pitch, that's why P by 2 cot theta by 2. And again, CD is equal to 1 by 2 H. CD, you can observe here, CD from this point to this point, CD is half of H. This is H, depth of a thread, H, right? CD is half of the H. You can write in terms of the H, in terms of CD. Now, if you substitute it, H value is this P by 2 cot theta by 2. This H value, if you substitute into this, it will become P by 4 cot theta by 2. So further, the small h, you can represent the h in terms of AD minus CD. AD minus CD, right? AD is, you can see here, AD is this equation what you got, D by 2 cosecant theta by 2, that is being substituted in this. And this CD value is, it is obtained here, half of H, that is P by 4 cot theta by 2, which is being substituted into this. See, finally, this distance over the wires, M is equal to distance over the wires, M is equal to E plus 2H plus 2R. Distance over the wire, M, this value, M is equal to E, effective diameter, plus 2 times the H, this one, right? 2 times the H, because H represent only half of this, 2 times the H plus 2 times the R. So finally, if you substitute this, you'll get this final equation, M value, diameter over the wires. M is equal to E plus D, 1 plus cosecant theta by 2 minus P by 2 cot theta by 2, right? This is the final equation you're going to obtain for the value of M, that is diameter over the wires. For this equation, M equation, suppose if it is a Whitworth thread. Whitworth thread means, you can see in the right side here, Whitworth thread, the angle, the thread angle is 55 degree. The theta value is 55 degree, right? And the depth of the thread here, what you can see over here, depth of the thread, it is standard, right? 55 degree is standard. Again, 0.64 P, P represent pitch. it is also standard. For each thread, the depth of thread as well as the angle of the thread, it is standard. That standard value here it has been considered. For Whitworth thread, suppose in problem, in the screw thread, what you are measuring, what you are inspecting, if it is a Whitworth thread, that is theta value is 55 degree and depth of thread is standard. These two are standards. 0.64 pitch. If you substitute these in the previous equation, that is in the equation M, this final equation, if you substitute it, this will become M is equal to D plus 3.1657 D minus 1.6005 P after substituting these values. The theta value, if you substitute into that, again here 55 degree, cosecant 55/2, cot 55/2, the values, finally going to get this equation, right? Where capital D represent major diameter of the thread. So this is the final equation. If the thread which you are using during the inspection is Whitworth thread, having a thread angle of 55 degree and depth of thread of 0.64 P. So this is the final equation which to be used. So anyhow, the diameter is known, small diameter, big major diameter will be also known. So again, the pitch, it is also known because the, for the screw thread, where you're going to get the this value. And these values, once you substitute, you're going to get the E value, effective diameter or pitch diameter value. Suppose in the second condition for metric threads, say metric thread means, so keep on telling from the previous classes, metric thread means the angle, the thread angle is 60 degree. You can observe here, V thread, metric thread or V thread, the angle, thread angle is 60 degree. And the depth of thread, it is standard again, 0.649P. For this, it is 0.64P. This is standard value, Whitworth thread. For metric thread, it is 0.6495P, standard values. Suppose these values, if it is been substituted, right, these values here, this is the final equation which you are going to obtain. M is equal to D plus 3D minus 1.5155P, where capital D is major diameter, small d is diameter of the wire, P represent pitch of the given screw thread. See here, we can measure the value of M practically and then compare with theoretical values with the help of formula derived. After finding the correct value of M and knowing the small d, E can be calculated, found out. E means it is effective diameter. So finally, the intention is to calculate or measure the effective diameter or pitch diameter of the given screw thread, whether it can be Whitworth thread having an angle of 55 degree or whether it can be a metric thread having an angle of 60 degree. So based on those, we can able to substitute, you can get the value of E. So this is about the small derivation to get to know the effective diameter or pitch diameter of the given screw thread by using three wire methods. Right? It is important. Usually in the VT exam, this will be asked. They're not going to ask the question in the form of derive. They're going to ask the question in the form of how to measure the effective diameter by using three wire method, or get the equation to measure the effective diameter by using three wire methods. So this will be the three wire method. Right? I hope you understood. Right? If any doubt are there, please unmute yourself. You can ask three wire method. Right? So two wire method, three wire method. Right? I hope all of you understood. So we'll move on to the next. Before going for the next topic, this how calculations will be done, that I'll going to tell you, right? So I hope all of you can see the screen over here, right? All of you can see the screen. This calculation or a numerical problem, it will not be there for your syllabus. This is the question which I have taken from the GATE question paper, right? Entrance exam GATE question paper I have taken it, because in order to make you to realize that what you are discussing, it is not that only for the theoretical purpose. It will be there in the future also, in the entrance exams or in the competitive exams. They may ask the questions in this way also. For that reason, in order to show you that I have taken it, it is not there in the syllabus, only for the reference, for the better understanding. So you can read the problem here. It is being asked a GATE question, right? See here, figure shows three wire method of inspecting the screw thread. You can observe here, three threads are there, two on one side, one on other side. The screw thread is ISO metric M16 with a pitch of 2 mm and effective diameter 14.70 mm. Diameter of the roller used for measurement is 1.155 and correspond to best wire diameter. Best wire means touches at points of effective diameter. So here, what need to calculate? The value of S, right? That is measurement over the wires from this point to this point. What could be the value for this? What could be the value? Anyone can able to tell that one? What could be the value here? This is the GATE question which has been asked, right? This one mark question in the entrance exam, usually they're going to ask it like this. Can you tell what could be the answer for this? What will be the S value? Measurement over the wires. You do the calculation later, right? All of your reasoning, right? You can able to do the calculation. The value of this S, it is 18.2, right? The value of this, it is 18.2. So I will show some other examples also. That is the problems which is asking the competitive exams, the MCQs, so that you can able to understand or realize what you are studying is not just for the theoretical purpose. It will be helpful in the future also, right? I hope you understood this. You do the calculation, right? So this will be the value. 18.2 millimeter will be the value of S, measurement over the wires, three wire method. Right? They can ask the question in the other way. Calculate the effective diameter, E value, right? So next topic, we'll discuss about this now. All of you can see the screen, right? Next topic, we'll want to discuss about this. As you can see the image here, right? This is the, we are going to discuss about the best wire. See, these are some of the conditions of the wires. Maximum wire, the maximum wire, it is not coming in contact with flank as well as the given wire. Minimum size also, see, only the best wire is the one which come in contact with the flank and the pitch line. This is the wire which is been selected. This is what the best wire means, right? This we are going to discuss now. Best wire, right? What is the equation to calculate the best wire size? That we will discuss now. Till now, what we discuss is how to measure the effective diameter by using two wire and three wire method. Now we are going to discuss about this best wire. I hope all of you are understanding, right? Best wire size. See, again, this is another important topic in this particular module. You see the VT question paper, this also been asked now numerous time to get the expression for the best size wire, right? That is, what is the equation to calculate the best size of the wire? That is here another small derivation, expression for best size wire. And I told earlier about what I mean by best wire means, best size wire means, it is one, it is the wire in which makes contact at pitch line. So this is the wire, this is best size wire. This is the best size wire which makes contact at the pitch line or effective diameter of the screw thread. effective diameter of the screw thread is measured from the pitch line, and with respect to that, if it make the contact, then it is considered as the best wire size. You can observe the previous slide also here, right? This is not the best wire. This is maximum. This is minimum. Only this is the one best size wire. How to calculate that best size wire? Because in these two wire method, three wire method, you are already using the wires here, two wire, three wires. You are already using. But how to select that wires? Right? Those wires. How to select it? That we are going to discuss. Suppose in this, you can see your 0.725, 0.725. How to select this with respect to the given screw thread? That expression we are going to discuss now. Right? There is a heading, it has been shown here. Expression for best size wire. So assume this figure, this is the given screw thread, and this is the best wire which has been selected. From this, we are going to derive the equation. Consider the half the thread angle be theta by 2. You can observe here on the screen, theta by 2 is the half of the thread angle, or you can call it as the flank angle, right? Half flank angle is half the thread angle. Consider a triangle OAP. You can observe here OAP. These are all important. Try to understand it, right? OAP. Consider this triangle OAP. This triangle OAP now, see here, sine POA. With respect to, I have taken this triangle over here. You can see over here, yellow curve one, for the sake of understanding, right? OAP. See, sine of POA, this angle is 90 minus theta by 2, right? See, sine POA, sine value is opposite by hypotenuse, right? Sine, the trigonometric function, sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. If you see this figure, opposite is this one. It is not the adjacent, because this is the angle, subtended angle, what we are going to discuss. POA angle, sine of POA, POA. So this will become opposite, this will become hypotenuse. So sine POA is equal to AP by OP. That is opposite by hypotenuse. Sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite is this one, AP. This is OP. Right? So this angle subtended, it is 90 minus theta by 2. This angle, it is 90 minus theta by 2. How we got this 90 minus theta by 2? This angle is 90, right? This is a right angle triangle. This side is 90. So obviously this is theta by 2. All of you are understanding, right? See the cursor. This is 90. At this point, it is theta by 2. So obviously this side is 90 minus theta by 2. The third side, it will become 90 minus theta by 2. So sine 90 minus theta by 2 is equal to AP by OP. Now this you can label right in terms of OP. So OP is equal to AP by sine 90 minus theta by 2. So now again conversion from this to cos. So all of you know sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. So all of you know, right? Sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. If you want to represent the cos in terms of sine, sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. For that reason, AP by cos theta by 2, it has been written. Sine theta, sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. There is a equation formula. So with respect to that, it has been taken as cos theta by 2. You can observe here, right? So finally, AP is equal to secant. Why that secant it become? 1 by cos theta is equal to secant theta, right? I hope all of your understanding, right? So AP by cos theta by 2. 1 by cos theta is secant theta. So AP secant theta by 2. OP value will become AP secant theta by 2. You can observe in this figure, main image OP. OP, it is representing the radius of this wire, right? That's why it represented as OP is equal to R, which is equal to AP secant theta by 2. And the diameter of the wire is 2 times the radius, that is 2R. So now best wire diameter, capital D suffix B, best size diameter. If it is represented B means this is with respect to best wire diameter. The suffix B represent best wire diameter, which is equal to 2 times the R. So R value is here AP secant theta by 2, 2 into AP secant theta by 2. Since AP lies on the pitch line, you can observe here, AP lies on the pitch line. This value of AP will become P by 4. From this point to this point, it is pitch. All of you can see this cursor. From this point to this point, that is the, from center of the one crest to the adjacent center of the one crest will be the pitch. In that, AP value is P by 4. That if you substitute into this AP value, this DB value will become, finally, DB value will become P by 2 secant theta by 2. All of, as you can observe over here, this is the tool maker microscope. You can observe here, there is a lamp is here, lamp. There is an eyepiece here, optical head is mentioned here. So obviously mirror is here, right? Obviously the principle based on which this works is on optics. It is a optical instrument, optical measuring instrument. You can see the previous slide here, tool maker microscope. Here it is there, right? Tool maker. It is also one of the instrument, but it is not a comparator. It actually gives the value of the dimension. Here, tool maker microscope, the principle based on which it works is based on optics. It uses the light source. Without power, without external power source, it can't function it, right? It uses the light. You can see here the schematic diagram of the tool microscope. Somewhat on the right side, what you are seeing, somewhat it will look like this. Again, this is the experiment which you are going to do in the triple M lamp individually, right? Individually, you are going to do this experiment, tool maker microscope. The instrument, it is there in the triple M lamp. See here, you can see over here, this is the base, robust base, right? Robust base on which this is the hollow base. You can observe here, this is the hollow base. Hollow base means empty space in it. In this empty space, there will be a light source, lamp. There will be a lens. There will be a mirror. Everything is accommodated inside this base itself, in the base itself. Right? In the base, you can observe here, in this base itself, it is being accommodated. The lamp, mirror, the collimator, lens. In some other type of tool maker microscope, it will be at the outer position. But anyhow, it uses optics to do the measurements. See again, here if you see on the top of the base, there will be work table. Work table. So on this only, you're going to place the component, the screw thread, for which you are actually going to do the measurement. The major diameter, minor diameter, the pitch, the angles, those things can be measured. That component will be kept on this work table. So this is the column. You can observe here also. This is the column. This is the optical head. Here you can observe. This is the eyepiece. You can observe here. This is the eyepiece. Through this eyepiece only, you're going to observe the image of the component on the graticule. Like this, the lines will be there, right? What you're seeing, like this dotted line will be there. By adjusting these lines with the profile of the thread, we're actually doing the measurement. See this hollow base, it consists of micrometer screws. You can observe this side also. This is a one micrometer, this is a micrometer screw, right? It is drum micrometer, bigger one. It can be the smaller normal micrometer also, right? So this is one side of the micrometer, it is for lateral movement. Another is with respect to this direction moment, because the component which is being kept on here, this portion, it has to be get adjusted with the these graticules. If you see through the eyepiece, it is like this, the image will be obtained. The shadow of the object can be viewed on through the eyepiece. The observer is going to see through the eyepiece like this. You can see that this is the actual profile of the thread. You can see there is a line here. You can observe here, right? These lines is the one which will go into adjust with the profile of this to measure the pitch, angle, major, minor diameter from one end to other end by moving these two micrometers either direction. He has to adjust it, then using the micrometer values only you can able to get the readings, major diameter, minor diameter, flank angle, thread angle, those things you can be measured. The pitch of a thread can be measured. See, 360 degree it can able to rotate. This work table, it can able to rotate in the any direction like this. What you are observing here, this it can be able to rotate. So this is the tool maker microscope, and actually some cases it will look like this. What you are seeing, tool maker microscope, it will be look like this, right? Eyepiece, hollow piece, column. This is the work table. These two are the micrometers. What you are observing, right? Through the eyepiece, you can able to observe the component. The image will be observed here through the eyepiece. This experiment you're going to do in the Triple M lab individually. This is the principle of reflection which is used for the measurement. The same image I'm taking here, you can observe light source, principle of measurement, light source. There is a mirror. The mirror will going to reflect the light which is going to incident onto it. While the light rays are going to the optical head while traveling, it will carry the image or shadow of the object which is kept here on the work table. If the object is kept while moving in this direction, it will carry the object shadow of it or the image of it, which will be projected onto the eyepiece, which the person can able to see here objective lens. Then again multiple times it will going to reflect because of the amplification purpose, right? See here, first time, second, then the third time, then finally through the eyepiece the person can able to see through the eyepiece. You set the component to the required profile, then you can able to take the reading. You can see this is the component, right? This will be the component which can be kept on the table. Major diameter, minor diameter, pitch, the thread angles, those things can be calculated on this table. This is the accurate method. Always the optical instruments will tend to be having more accuracy in measurement as compared to the mechanical measuring instruments because less friction, less component come in contact. So less component, less friction means obviously you're going to have more of the amplification in the optical instruments. So accuracy will be more. So this is what the toolmaker microscope is about. This experiment you're going to perform in the Triple M lab. This is the through the eyepiece you can able to adjust the dial from what angle to what angle. Those dotted line, what you able to see, those things you have to set with respect to the profile of the screw thread, the shadow. Then you can able to take the reading very accurately. So this is the optical based on the optics, it's going to work. Tool maker microscope. In the short form, it is called as TMM, tool maker microscope. Right? I hope all of you understood this tool maker microscope. So this is what it looked like. This is the optical measuring instrument to measure those parameters of the given screw thread. See now the question, MCQ question, right? You can observe on the screen. Most accurate instrument is, don't consider that yellow color, this one selection, right? That is not the answer which I marked. Which answer will be that among the four option? More accurate instrument is, irrespective of the measurement, which instrument is considered as more accurate, most accurate one among the four option? Vernier caliper is there, screw gauge is there.
A D,
right? Optical projector. As I told now itself, as I told previously, optical instruments are more accurate, right? The option is optical projector. Optical instrument is more accurate. The option is D, correct. Another one, so you have taken with the question number only as it is, right? Another question, the flatness of machine bit. This is with respect to the previous one. The flatness of machine bed. Machine bed means either on the drilling machine or milling machine. The bed of the machines. How to do the measurement? Can be measured using which measuring instrument among the four options? Vernier caliper is there. Is that can be used to measure the flatness of the bed? Autocollimator is there. Height gauge is there. Toolmaker microscope is there. Toolmaker microscope just we discussed. Which instrument is used to measure the flatness? Height gauge. Height
water, gauge. Water, sir. What?
Autocollimator. Autocollimator we discussed previously. Autocollimator, right? Autocollimator. Using the principle of the optics, the bed in the regular class in the college itself, I explained that one. The bed, the straightness, the flatness of the bed. This experiment also will be going to perform in the triple M lab. Autocollimator is also there to measure the flatness, to measure the straightness of the object. It can be used to do the measurement. Is autocollimator. This is the instrument to measure the flatness. Right. These are some of the applications of toolmaker microscope, what you are observing. Linear measurements, measurement of pitch of the screw, measurement of pitch diameter, thread angle, center to center distance measurement. If this is the object, we can do these type of measurements, application of toolmaker microscope. It is not used to measure the flatness, it is just used to measure